2 days after being assaulted in a street fight, a 57-year-old man presents with chest pain and back pain. His troponin, NT-proBNP, and creatine kinase are all very high. But is this really a heart attack or something else? The pain is sharp, radiates to the left arm, and worsens with the hand movement. On exam, he has tenderness over the chest wall and upper back. So, what would you do next? Angiography with stent implantation, angiography without stent, or no angiography at all? Comment your choice before we continue. Now let's look at his ECG. There is slight ST elevation and negative T waves in lid 1. In AVL, there is a pathological Q wave with the same ST-T changes, suggesting lateral wall myocardial infarction. In the chest lids, there are pathological Q waves with ST elevation and T wave inversion from V1 to V3, pointing to anteroseptal wall. Lid V4 shows loss of the R wave, ST elevation and T inversion, signs of anteroapical wall involvement. Altogether, there are dynamic ECG changes of myocardial infarction. Angiography confirmed a 100% occlusion of the proximal LAD. But here is the twist. His symptoms are consistent with musculoskeletal chest injury, not angina. And because more than 48 hours have passed since presentation and there are no ongoing ischemic symptoms, current ECG guidelines do not recommend stent implantation. So this patient had a myocardial infarction caused by blunt chest trauma. Possible mechanisms include intimal tear, coronary dissection, spasm, vessel rupture, plaque rupture, or even external compression. Follow for more real ECG dilemmas.